to another Ranked Replaycast, and this time I'm featuring Monus71, who's playing the Conqueror. Yeah, I know Ranked is over, but still I have some nice replays in the back that got sent in by some viewers of mine, and I think they are commentator worthy. And yeah, this is one of them. So we are playing on Ridgeline. And let's look quickly at the lineups. So one battleship each. Okay, if you exclude the enemy starting crowds, which basically counts as another battleship. Apart from that, a lot of cruisers. And if I play Conqueror, then I'm switching automatically already to armor piercing ammunition. I'm getting into an aggressive position. That's my first goal. Because of the concealment and the Conqueror, yeah, you want to be a bit more aggressive than other battleships. I mean, Yamato can't do that because he can't get undetected, but you as a Conqueror, you can do that. For those who watched my stream, I like this position above this island here, and I think that's where Monus is also heading to. Maybe learned that from me, I don't know, or found that position also appealing. He's accompanied by Hindenburg, which is okay. And yeah, it looks as if the Yu Yang is going A. With this amount of potential radars or radar ships, like Des Moines is 100% radar, I imagine. Stalingrad as well. Minotaur most likely as well. Depends on the bracket. And therefore, you can count like three radar ships, so I don't mind that Yu Yang is going to A, since C depends on the information you have, and the information is basically zero right now, except that there is a smoke, so that could be from the Minotaur, or either could be from the Z-52. If I would play a Z-52, I would keep my smoke for myself, but that's a different story. Des Moines is going into a position to radar C, which is always good. That speaks for him. And yeah, that has to be seen. So, C is contested with a Z-52. Excuse me, guys. And you see this position here. You have a good shot over this whole C cap. The only position that is more or less safe is this island. But that's it. And yeah, that Z-52 brought himself into trouble, because he can be shot from here or here. So, depends on how quick you are in the D, you can cap it from here, even with a lot of radar. But you have to have backup. And yeah. Also, a good advantage of this island is you are covered from down here, from the spam. Not where Monus is right now, a bit more to the left where the Hindenburg is, that would be the optimal position. For Hindenburg, I don't like this position too much, because if he gets shot in broadside, then he might eat citadels from battleships. But since there is, in this lineup, only one battleship, the danger is, let's say, minimal. Yeah. And one thing, if Monus would have had loaded AP, the Z-52 is angled and also pretty vulnerable to AP, so that would be, as I said, the first choice of doing it. And you get full penetration if he's angled like this. And he doesn't see that. Too late. Okay, blind shooting. But of course, I would at least start to use AP now. I mean, with only one battleship, there are so many cruiser broadsides that you can punish, especially in the Conqueror, because you can sneak on them and then surprise them. Conqueror is kind of the, I mean, someone called it the Mega Zao, but it's not all only because of the HE firepower it has, it is also because of the concealment, in which you can surprise attack some cruisers. And yeah, has some things going for it. So, lonely Des Moines down here, and still, but I have to criticize, why not shooting AP? So, okay, if you don't have expert loader, I don't mind it, shoot the first volley. HE. But what I have to mention is, the good anticipation. So he sees most of the enemies there, so we can play aggressive, and most people would still sit here and just wait for something to happen. And Moniz is going aggressive here, but still loads HE for some reason. That's a thing I don't agree on, and you won't avoid that. The ammo choice is on the Conqueror really important thing. Concentrate fire on that enemy warship. Absolutely important, and yeah. When I played Conqueror, I always played dependent on the enemy lineup. So if there are a lot of battleships, of course I have HE loaded. If there are a lot of cruisers or destroyers, then I'm going for AP first. And then occasionally switch to the battleship for HE or so. That's basically what you want to do. He somehow still didn't switch. Yeah, that's... The Moin down here is in a big, big trouble. I think he needs to run, especially now. If I would be at the Moin, I would wait until Moniz has shot and then just run and try to kite. But since he's still staying there, he will definitely die unless he gets enough support from the other side. Okay, there's the starting card coming over. He can also play pretty freely, to be honest, because there's no big threat for him, except for the Conqueror. That's a downside of the Conqueror. Conqueror is not really precise with the AP, and the AP can be devastating, but doesn't have to. And especially against Hindenburg, you struggle sometimes if they angle their ship really well, in my opinion. Yeah, but this is still HE. I don't get this. If it's... I mean, if that would have been important and you don't have all the time to shoot the cruiser, or if you're under fire from multiple ships, now he switches to AP. Because then, I mean, a Des Moines or a Wooster, they have such a DPM, they can melt the Conqueror pretty quickly if they are. If you let them. Fire. That aim was not good, I think. Way too high. But okay. 10k in the buff area. I would have aimed for the frontal citadel, because you can overmatch the bow. But yeah, at least he's shooting AP now. Yeah, and there we go. That's the result here. Maybe could have had a bit earlier and could have saved your Hindenburg, who was, I think, a bit too aggressive there. He didn't turn around when he should have. But okay. Enemy Minotaur still spotted. I like that you didn't use your heal now. Now you use your heal because the reload, but you could have waited for a second. Yeah, that Minotaur makes a critical error. Even though he's not spotted, I would have shot the same. If you're lucky, you delete him. Bam. Yep. That's the thing you don't want to do in a Minotaur. An enemy cruiser. So, last spotted target down here, Montana, while the rest is occupying their Sau and the Hindenburg. Stalingrad is going aggressive into C and is working on the... on the Des Moines. But basically, it's not such a close game right now, but it's it actually shows the difference between certain players. I mean, if I would have been Moniz shooting AP, I think would have been much more successful. He has already a good game. Of course, against a slightly angled Montana, you want to shoot HE, that's for sure. And he's doing exactly that. Kiting away is totally fine, there's no pressure to go into a close quarters fight and to risk your ship. So you go for HE and kite away. Maybe you realize that there is a Stalingrad up there in C-Cap. Maybe you can help out here Des Moines, which would be great. Because you don't want to have a Stalingrad on your side, that's for sure. Okay, Stalingrad takes out the Des Moines. so. I think you showed a bit too much broadside to the Montana, but doesn't matter. You have your heal available in a second. If that would be a close game, I would be aware that... Oh, you have to be aware that you can't kite away for ages. That's really important. Because you're practically out of position. Okay, the enemy battleship is as well, but if your ships up here would have been outnumbered, you want to be the one who's back in business as quick as possible to save the game. But I think in this case it's not so such a tragic thing. But it's a thing you have to definitely have to watch out for. Also, this Montana is just waiting for your broadside. Always when you're turning in, he's shooting AP, which is smart. So maybe just fire your back guns, and when he's not patient anymore, then let him shoot his AP volley, and then you're firing your front guns. So bringing out bring him out of this kind of sequence, because he's always waiting for your broadside. You see, he's turning in. He's turning to shoot all of your guns. Okay, in this case you were slightly better angled, but if someone is just always waiting for you to have good broadside shots, then just play the back gun, front gun sequence. And what I also like is that he doesn't know if he's going to be shot at with HE or AP, and did switch around. That's a good upside. If I would have been, for example, that Montana, I would have switched to HE already. And maybe also kited away, because this win, this fight he can't win normally. Nice kill there, and the game is won. So I think overall really well played. Ammo choices is the only thing I would criticize. Apart from that, good anticipation when you have room to push, and when you have time to roam, and of course some really good deletions as well. So a well-deserved win, I would say. And thanks Monus for 71 for sending this in. I think that was maybe helpful for the players, even though ranked is over now. But for the next season, this these are mandatory things you always need to embrace, and I always try to show it every and now and then when I can. And that's the case with this replay as well. All right, folks. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did so, just give it a like. Apart from that, if you ran into my content and you like it and you want to see more of it, or you want to support the channel, then consider a subscription. That's also pretty nice of you. Finally, I wish you a good day and see you next time. Bye bye.